to one of War Thunder's training areas. Here, you will learn how to control your vehicle. Begin moving forward. Follow the waypoints to the firing area. Right corner, you can see a mini-map which shows your tank as an arrow. It also shows the position of your enemies and allies as icons. Your opponent this time, a training target, is the red icon on the map. You can see several markers on the screen. The cursor, which the turret of your tank follows, the marker indicates. Take into consideration that the mouse-aiming cursor is not a gun sight and serves to help you turn the tank turret in the right. If you want to hit the enemy tank, wait for the turret to turn towards the opponent. Align the crosshair with the target. It will change color when it is over the opponent. And fire. Wait until the tank turret switch to gunner view. You can use zoom to get a better view of the target. The aim assist indicator in the center of the screen shows where the shell will strike when you fire a shot. It turns red if the current shell cannot pierce the armor. Depending on your target's armor thickness, one of the best ways to destroy a tank is to put its crew out of action. Move the reticule over the central area of the tank. Now, fire at the fighting compartment on the tank.
Got it!
When a shell penetrates armor, the enemy tank is considered destroyed if it has. Another effective way of destroying, or at least immobile, most armored vehicles have their engines at the rear. Continue by moving the reticule onto the rear of the indicated tank. Now, switch to gunner view and fire at the tank engine.
On target!
If the engine, ammo rack, or fuel tanks in. Good job! Move on to another caponier.
The enemy tank has been destroyed!
Now, you have to complete a real combat assignment. You can see a marker above the capture point. Move to the capture zone. Capture the zone. Wait for the marker to turn blue and for a message to appear notifying you that you have captured the zone.
Allied forces have captured a zone.
The capture zone's marker has turned blue. Capturing strategic points is one of the main When one team captures more strategic points than the other team, the enemy team begins to lose points. Victory is achieved when the enemy team loses all its points. So, always try to keep control of the strategic zones. Great job! You won! Now you're a true tanker. Thank you. Welcome to part one of the basic tutorial. Here, you will learn in mouse aim mode, you can point your... That's it. Proceed to the waypoint. Increase the throttle to fly faster. Increase the throttle to 100%. Decrease the throttle to fly slower. You can see the aircraft's current engine power percent. As you can see, the aircraft increase the throttle until war emergency power is enabled. Hold the button to continue flying with WEP. The WEP lets you fly at maximum speed. Each mission has its own goals and objectives, which... Your first enemy is before you, a balloon. It's practically immobile. To destroy... You can see several markers on the screen. You will be unable to hit your opponent if you move the targeting cursor onto them with your mouse. The rounds will fly in the direction that the crosshair is aimed. You will also be unable to hit a moving object if you move the targeting crosshair directly onto it, as the target will move while the rounds fly forward and the burst will miss. To hit the opponent, put the targeting crosshair over the lead angle indicator of the enemy plane and fire. You need to fire right at it to hit the target. Aim and keep the mouse in. Now your aircraft has started to turn towards the target. You need to aim the crosshairs at the lead angle indicator. You will be unable to hit your opponent if you move the targeting cursor onto them with your mouse. The rounds will fly in the direction that the crosshair...
forces have captured a zone.
Hit!